we are not under pressure at all. Looking at our performance, looking at the nature of the team we sent, and looking at the preparation we had, we are not under pressure. And I believe we are actually looking forward for the next engagement. And it is the best next engagement whereby we feel we can even progress from fifth to go to the semi-finals. So I'm really happy. And that's why I made sure I'm here to receive our gallant athletes and welcome them home. And we our heads are up. And you want to welcome them and give them a decent welcome. That's why we're here this evening.
Abamele, around Ugandans, how do you secure this?
The government funding in Uganda has become a big problem. We all know that. And it is something we need to plan, knowing that our expectation shouldn't be really too much. I'm happy that the government of Uganda came in with around $20,000. We had a budget of far above $50,000, but we managed to move on. They came in, and then we progressed, but still there was no need of lamenting. The most important thing for us sportsmen to do is to show cause, get good results, put them on the table and tell them this is what we have and we want to go for this engagement. Most government officials are telling that it is either ill-planned, they don't know our progress, but right now we have something to put on the table. We are the best in the region. We are able to beat teams far from West Africa. That is Burkina Faso. We're able to beat teams like in Central Africa. That is the DRC. We have done well, and actually we need to progress. Being number five, the next thing to do is to become in the podium. That is being among the first four. And I believe government should listen to our heed to make sure that they come to our rescue. We didn't want to make hullabaloos like some federations have been making. I'm twisting, but if somebody is decent, like the way we have really shown, I believe we need to be welcomed and really progress with the sports in this country. Honestly, if you look at this year, we had the medals, Olympics, we had the basketball, we had the AFCON qualifiers. Look at which investments we have done, the colossal investments. Others haven't gone beyond qualification, and for us, we have been at the podium of Africa. Although not the podium, we have been at the helm of Africa, and we managed to be number five, and we believe we can progress if really we are facilitated. Our teams never had access to the indoor facilities. We're just training in Nkumba outdoors. Really, the conditions we operate in to get these results were not good, but I'm happy that we really got the best we have ever got in this country as far as volleyball is concerned.
COVID-19 ravaged everyone and must have ravaged volleyball. Yes, we are number five in Africa, but there's a lot of work to be done on the ground here. We've lost 2 years. What are the plans like?
The plan is to open the league. If we open the league, the good thing the president accepted the outdoor games. Let us open. We are planning to open the league to make sure that we can start competition at club level, at the national level. And as soon as they open schools, we shall also start the competition at school level. And in that process, we shall be able to open up. There are many athletes whom we could not think of, but because of lack of competition for the last 2 years, it was very difficult to know their fitness levels. And with that, it was very hard for us really to know who is where. We managed to assemble the team, obviously looking at the history, and sometimes the young athletes were very difficult to pick on, and look in consideration that most of our team is almost in the 20s. So there was a challenge, but we are looking forward to start the league. And if we start the league, competition will go a lot more. The scouters will be looking at the athletes and be able again to rebuild and build on the team we have. At least now we have a skeleton.